Hey chat, what do you know about Evony?
Well, Evony, or Evony the King's Return, is a popular mobile and online strategy game. It's basically a real-time strategy game where you build cities, manage resources, train troops, and form alliances. Players often engage in large-scale battles and diplomatic maneuvering. It's got a pretty dedicated community, and a lot of people get really into optimizing their strategies and coordinating with their alliance members.
Can you help me extract data from Evony battle reports?
Absolutely, I can definitely help you with that. Just share any battle report screenshots or the details you have, and I'll do my best to walk you through extracting the info you need.
So this is what I've been trying to do. In an earlier video, I did this. It's, in images, you can take screenshots of the report and ask AI to help you to convert those numbers into tables and easily put them in the Excel file. I did some experiments, if you may, and my conclusion so far is that if you can use the project option is the best. So I continued with those experiments, and now what I did is I created a custom GPT that does exactly that. So there are good news and bad news. The good news is that it does work and it is quite stable. But as you might have noticed in the previous video, the version of ChatGPT I was using was 4.0, and currently the latest model is 5. And for free tier users, you cannot go back to this legacy model. But this custom GPT requires using 4.0. The reason is that 4.0 has image reading capabilities natively, so it can extract text from the screenshots. But the newer model, 5, does not have those capabilities. What it does instead is using available OCR tools that are not so good, especially because Evony interface is not that clear in terms of text, so it cannot really extract the data that we need in those models. But as long as you have a subscription for ChatGPT, you can use this, and the link is down below in the description. So it extracts three types of data: troops, traps, buffs, and debuffs. I had to make them separate. Ideally, I wanted it to take all of the screenshots of different parts of the battle report and generate one single output with different sheets of different types of data. But working with GPT is just like working with a Gen Z student who has a very short attention span. So it starts to drift away along the way. So it's better to break it up into smaller tasks. So if you, for example, choose the type is you want to input the troop data of one player in the battle report, it first asks you the name of the player. It's optional, it's just to name the sheet in the Excel file it provides, and then you need to upload the images, and then it creates the file for you. So this is one example that I provided it with screenshots, and then it generated the file that I up downloaded and then continued with new players. It's usually better to do one by one and create a new chat. But the output looks something like this. And if it generates it correctly formatted, it should look like this one. As you can see, you have three blocks for survive, the losses, and for killing. This basically matches the input for the battle analysis tool that I have. Again, you can find a link in the description and also in the previous video on this. So sometimes it might miss like one row, like in this case it didn't take my T15 ground. If there is a weird pattern in the data, that could happen. For example, in this one I did actually lose all of my troops, but To GPT, it was a real thing, so it recorded the number of killed as survived, but it wasn't something big. I just copy-paste this to the other field. It should have improved after several iterations that I tried to improve the configurations. So for traps, it is pretty much the same, and for buffs and debuffs also, but the only thing is that if you wanna extract buff and debuff data, it asks if it is an attack or a defense report so that it knows which column is which. Again, it's good to double check afterwards. So at the end, I'm not 100% happy with this. It's needed a lot of time, and the output is not as straightforward as I hoped it would be, but it is still better than having to put enter things manually in an Excel file. Maybe if you try it, you find some specific patterns that I can fix. Let me know. You can actually leave a review for this, right in there. If you face some issues with this, I will try to make some time and fix this. But it has been, I've been using this personally for a few battle reports, and I've been pretty happy with it. I mean, it's not like I can take 2 minutes to fully analyze a battle. It takes a bit of time to take the screenshots, upload them here, and get the files back and make sure the file is correct. But it does, at the end of the day, it has been doing pretty well. I've been positively impressed with it at the end. Hopefully, it stays like that with the new models. It doesn't start acting weirdly again. But that's it. I just wanted to share with you this progress on and share the custom GPT for you to use. Hopefully, it will be of use for you. Until the next video.